I don't know if you know this, but when a government says something is free, it's not. And this is the very important lesson that we're learning right now in the state of New York, which I am a part of, sadly. I don't know what the hell I'm doing here, but the financial repercussions of this free mentality are finally coming to realization as New York City is coming close to bankruptcy and is edging towards financial disaster because of just the utter lunatics who are running the local government here. Now, as someone who lives here in New York City, I could testify to the very fact that the city is cash strapped to extreme extents where they view the people as cattle that they milk for as much money as they freaking could get from you. It's absolutely ridiculous. I'm even scared to go outside sometimes in New York City because of just the rampant police state and cracking down of minor offenses that, of course, the local police departments, that local traffic enforcement officers use here to generate money for the state. An endless, hungry, bureaucratic monster in New York City, as well as New York State, just can't be filled with enough money. And this is true when you look at everything that's happening, especially through existing in this city. You could go into a subway with a cup of coffee. That's a fine. You run in the metro, that's a fine. You speed a little bit, speed cameras will get you and they're going up everywhere. Oh, you're delivering food on an electric bike? Well, that's a whole fine in itself and they're gonna take the bike away. Oh, you're driving a regular pedal bike and you just somehow go onto the curb for even just a little bit? That's a fine. And still, with some of the highest taxes in all of the United States, still with the amount of fines and tickets and penalties and regulations and just extortion fees that the local governments get from local people, still, they are going broke and can't even run a metro system successfully or properly. And that should be the bigger kind of question here. If a government can't even run the trains well, why would you even entrust in an institution that is corrupt, has been corrupt for a very long time, is all about power, is all about money? Why would you entrust this institution to run all the other aspects of your life? Now, of course, a lot of people here celebrated that New York City was offering free healthcare, free tuition for some college students, free legal advice, free services, free sanctuary city. We'll give you everything for free. And guess what? All of it is based on just an absolute lie. None of it's free. A lot of it comes from taxes. A lot of it comes from extortion. A lot of it comes from the fees. And for some still insane reason, they want more money. And the current mayor of New York City wants to add billions of dollars to the budget that was already swollen, fat, gross, a bureaucratic blob of corrupted goo, which of course is not good for business. The city is proposing to spend $89.2 billion, and on what? You walk around the streets of New York City, what are you spending that money on, you imbeciles? Since Mayor de Blasio took office, spending has increased 32%. And guess what? This situation is only going to get disastrous moving forward, because if you look at the raw numbers, 1% of taxpayers in New York City amount to 50% of the tax revenue. That 1%, I don't know what's keeping them here. I don't know what's keeping me here. It's a love-hate relationship with the city, but that's a whole nother thing. This is why I'm even personally working on behind-the-scenes content on where to expat from, because this is something I'm seriously considering, because this city has completely just gone to shite, and it's only going to continue to go to shite, obviously with more taxes, obviously with more regulations and more restrictions to fit for this economic calamity caused by these buffoons who can't get enough of your money. And soon enough, that 1% is obviously going to do the smart, intelligent thing and leave. Now, personally, I don't even make that much money, barely any, and I'm still getting taxed heavily, which again is just one of many reasons why it's time to leave this city. Now, of course, with many economic experts predicting a recession happening economically and very soon on the horizon, this leads to a very disastrous situation where most likely New York City won't even be able to pay off the long-term pensions for a lot of the pensioners. And what is most likely happening here is, of course, already New York City, number one place nationwide, state and local and city taxes, highest in the nation, are probably going to go even higher. Property taxes are probably going to go higher, since half of the the city's revenue already comes from it, where you're not even a property owner. You can't even own a piece of land without the government coming to you with their gang of you know, let's call it thugs, saying, hey, you live here? Give me some money right now for the privilege of buying something and owning something. Yeah, expect those numbers to go up as well, which of course, naturally it will. And with the city unable to take on new debt because of the disastrous situation it has set up, especially with the reality that the creditors have about the situation, this should be a very important lesson, not only for the people of New York City, but the people of this country, especially the new up-and-coming representatives, government representatives who think that socialism is great, who think that government spending is great, who think that more government to a bad government already creating problems is a great idea, because it's not. And New York City is going to be the perfect example of that. It is totally going down, and I'm getting the hell out of here as fast as I can. Again, nothing's free. The free pre-K, the free universal health care, the free college tuition, it's not free. It's all a scam. That just honestly does not work. Why? Well, because power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely. And of course, there's going to be many people who are like, but free education and free healthcare sound wonderful. Well, there, Bobo, you got to understand here, education is really indoctrination. The medical industry, corrupt as hell. Big Pharma has pretty much taken that over, many times creating a worse situation for your problem than the one that you actually came in. Now, again, there are some individuals in the medical industry that do an amazing job, but the whole industry by and large, especially the insurance industry, they're corrupted as fudge. Family friend of the show, we can't curse here. And why should I give my money, a portion of something that I honestly earned, towards institutions that are corrupt and are leaving people off worse than they began with? In the extreme examples, oh, you got some pain? Here, have some OxyContin. Oh, we have a heroin epidemic. Where did that come from? But we need more medical care to do this corrupt bullcrap to the American people. Oh, we have a whole bunch of people who are just literal freaking indoctrinated yes men and women who just say, yeah, sure, just tell me what to do without even critically thinking about important issues. Well, thank you, education system. Yeah, I definitely feel happy about my money going to those indoctrination camps. Yeah, that's a great waste of my money. And yet again, this is just some of the reasons why I detest the bigger governments that are establishing themselves and are setting themselves up for ultimate failure. And when it falls down, it's going to affect and hurt a lot of people who are becoming more and more dependent on that government teat. People need to be independent of that, working as individuals without business being stifled or taxed to death. And that is the basic core principles of anarchy, of liberty, of freedom. That is just simple, and people should understand. The opposite of that is, of course, centralization, more government, more control, more someone in the middle standing saying, hey, I'm the mafia here, give me some money to even exist and operate or even stay on this piece of land, which is absolutely ridiculous and the opposite of what free will and few humanity should have on this planet as we are coexisting here together. And that's why, along with just the stupid fines and tickets that you get in this city, is again one of the reasons why I'm studying, investigating, going to different expat communities all over the world to try to investigate a better place to live other than this crap hole, bureaucratic, tax-written, police state hellhole that is New York City. That's just my opinion. If you think I'm wrong, let me know why in the comment section below. And as always, I always appreciate you guys. That's why we're doing so many important videos on the backup channel. So make sure you subscribe, click the notification button, because we're going to have a lot more content coming here your way at We Are Change.